Today we're rating AI-generated cards! Magic the Gathering cards. Alright, we gotta start off with the Mad Few. It's a blue-blue 4 generic 4-4 Eldrazi drone. And whenever a player casts a spell, that player sacks a creature. To be honest, it's symmetrical, so I don't actually think it's broken in any way. And it's 6 mana. This actually looks like a real card that Wizards of the Coast could actually print. And it's an Eldrazi. You know what? It might be unfair in the Eldrazi deck because they got those Eldrazi Scions, those little Eldrazi squirrely tokens. Yeah, they produce a lot of stuff that they would want to sacrifice, so it would just be a downside to everybody else. Oh, and it's any spell. You want to cast like an artifact? You sack a creature. You want to play an enchantment? You sack a creature. You want to play a planeswalker? You sack a creature. You want to play a creature? You sack a creature. Good lord. Do you know what? Actually, this would be really good. I'm trying to think, like, maybe a combo deck would want to play this. But if the combo deck plays this, then they have to. Then they have a deck that they also can't do anything else unless they want to sacrifice their Mad Few. And it will be a Mad Few at the rate that you're casting spells. Okay, I think this is a real card. This is like a real card. We're going to move on. We got the... What is this? The Bell, if it's... Breathemies, he only a single armor ungiven to stand. All right, Bell for short. One red, one generic for a 2/1 creature. It is a creature confirmed. Creature type not. Can't see it under all that armor. And it's a vanilla creature, actually. The strength of the sigil is just another day at dusk. The birds and beasts are born into the underworld. Sparky's like, let's print it. Alright, we'll print this one too. I have no comment. It's got a fantastic, really long name. Broken by a comma. Yeah, ship it for flavor text. Ship it for flavor text. El Gran Fatso. If you have no creatures and you play a creature, you wouldn't have to sack it, right? Since the trigger would go on the stack while you have nothing on board. Well, if you have no creatures in play... Oh yeah, that's true. Yep. In regards to the last card, if you have no creatures in play, you could play a creature on into an empty board, and you get to keep the creature, but don't play any more spells, or you'd lose them all. Very interesting design. All right, move away, island. Okay, Return to Care, our best loyal to the court, yeah. Black 2 generic 1/1 Rhino Mutant. Whenever Return to Care, our best loyal to the court, yeah, attacks. You may pay 2 if you do gain 5 life. That's a real card! I'm sure there's a lot of people who want to play with a rhino that gains 5 life all the time. You just attack the person that's open. Alright, let's go. We're gonna say this is a pass. There's really not much else to say about this. A lot of long names. Yeah, the court, yeah? Attack for 1, pay 2, gain 5 life. The Aswend in the World, 3 generic artifact. Whenever a player casts an instant or sorcery spell, create a token that's a copy of Aswend in the Worlds. This does nothing, right? It literally does nothing. It just puts more artifacts onto the battlefield. I guess some people would want that. You might be able, you know, you might get some sort of effect based on how many artifacts that are in play, and you can return them. I don't know. Yeah, some very, very weird affinity enabler. I'm sure there is some combo deck that actually might want to play this. Like they keep playing spells, they keep getting artifacts, and then maybe they can tap their artifacts for mana. I mean, imagine you have Urza in play. So imagine you have Urza in play, and for every artifact in play, you get like blue mana. Just constantly get blue mana. It's not legendary either. This is actually really interesting. Whenever a player casts an instant or sorcery, and it's anyone! So it's anybody else that does anything, oh, sorry, instant or sorceries, we get artifacts. We get this Aswend in the Worlds. And Aswend in the Worlds goes deep. Yeah, City Blessing? Triggers City's Blessing? Maybe we can animate all these artifacts into creatures? Improvise helps with improvise. Tutor things into play. Yeah, Urza would definitely love this. Tap it for that Urza mana. Although we depend on our opponents playing instants and sorceries, but I guess it's a really unique way of, I don't know, taxing people from playing their spells. You think this would get banned? I mean, maybe. I don't know. It's a very bizarre card. It does nothing, and yet it multiplies. It's like a virus. You can turn them into elk with Oko. You know, Tom, you're not thinking big enough here. Not thinking big enough. All right, there we go. Arcbound Ravager. Sack all them Aswend in the worlds. And it looks like it goes deep. It goes in infinite. Mr. Deadhead says, you found my custom card. See you later. You can't even destroy it because it just... That's right! No, you could. You have to destroy all of them. So you cast, like, destroy all artifacts. The thing would trigger. The artifact comes into play and then you blow them all up at once. So you either go for them all or none at all. I think this is a cool card. I think this is this passes. I don't think it would be too... It's a build-around card. You build around it. Your opponents have to also cooperate a little bit. I mean, I guess you could just be the one playing the instants and sorceries. Mark or Peter with a sniper rifle of some sort. And three hands, if I see that correctly. Isn't that weird with the AI? They, like... I don't know, they don't keep track of how many limbs are being used in an image. I see that we've got one, two, three hands. All right, red two generic for a 3/5 Snaper. We've got to snape him. Is that supposed to be Snape from Harry Potter? Snape, the sniper. In another world, he was, yeah, he a sniper. In another world, he was a really good shot. All right, so we have... It's 3/5 creatures. That's a really beefy sniper. Snipers usually don't have big stats. That's why they got into the sniping business. Pay two and a white. Tap. S, create X. +1/+2 counters with Mark or Peter. Well, it didn't make any sense. Well, it was a cool card up until that point. You had us in the first half. It was all set up so well. It was a legendary creature, Snaper. There's only one Snape. Snape from Camp Lazlo. I don't relate. I have no idea. Three hands help with reloading, I guess. Oh, yes. In that world, three hands are better than two. Limited format, I would draft this just for the 3/5 for two and an R. The limited players out there looking at, oh my god, this is busted. 3/5 for three mana. All right, we can move it on. We got the door tile, a green one generic for a 1/1 Vingress. It's not very often we see words down there now, do we? It's got flying and level 4. How to get to level 4, I don't know. So this actually fails because it doesn't really specify how to get to level 4 flying. There's no cat. I don't know, do you just pay nothing? Okay, it flies now. I have a 1/1 flyer that has Vingress in the power and toughness box. And what that does, I don't know. Record consecutive pass AI cards. Yeah, I know. There's a lot of real cards, but now we're going deep into the AI machine where things don't make any sense anymore. Depths of the Snow against the World Auk. It's a white instant. Target creature deals damage to itself equal to its power. That is a cool card. The Angels is a seamed wheel at home. Flavor text could use some work, but the rest of the card actually works. Yeah, ship it for confusion. It hurt itself in confusion. Print it sheep. That must be a card already, right? I've never heard of a card like this, where you make a creature deal damage equal to its power. This looks like such a real card. Like, what is wrong with a white one mana, like, removal spell like that? And there's gonna be a ton of creatures out there that will not die to their own power. So it doesn't hit everything. I think it's a pretty sweet card. Riaz is already looking to put in the Brash Taunter deck, of course. Oh my goodness. Yeah, okay, if it's a 1/4 with Death Touch, I guess it just kills itself. Down in one shot. Yeah, playable and makes sense. Except the flavor text. And also, I don't really understand the depths of snow against the world Auk. Is Auk even a word? quickly looking up Auk. Causing uneasy embarrassment, awkward, or uncomfortable situation. That's what Auk. Against the world, awkward situation. Yeah, it's awkward to be in the middle of nowhere, doesn't it? Anyway, super pass. Playing Gross Spell. We got a blue, 2 generic, instant fortifier. Choose target attacking or blocking creature. I choose... attacking creature, I choose you. Who's that magic card? It's... Door Tile! It's Door Tile over there. Yeah, just choose it. I choose this creature. Alright, I choose it as well. Repentance and Tempest is the same as Depths, but white 2 for the casting cost. Alright, so this is just a more OP version of that card. The Depths. I really don't know. Choose who block? Choose target attacking or blocking. Oh! Actually, okay. Okay, so like when declare attackers, maybe you can force people to attack. Yeah, so like declare attackers, I will play the playing Gross Spell, and you have to attack with that creature. Or before the blocker step, I choose what you have to block with. All right, so this is a little bit more than just like, because sometimes the AI card, we've gone through so many A cards, they're like just point at the creature and then that's all it does. It will kill the illusions as well. It's got that, it's got a bonus in that way as well. When a work day is finished, but the card isn't done yet. Yeah, still dangerous because of the fortifies. I don't know what the fortifier synergy is. What's fortifier? Look, Osef, your guess is as good as ours. The AI just made it up. At what I'm assuming before the step happens, I'm assuming, because if it's too late, it's too late. Choose target attack. It's like, I guess I can choose this as an attacker. Then when the turn passes through, it has to attack. And same thing with blocks. I choose a blocker before the blocker step. And then when you hit the blocking step, it like it works. I'm trying hard to make this thing work. Since it has attacking, it's assumed that it was already declared. Choose target attacking or blocking creature. Alright, we put it in the bin. We put it in the bin. This card don't work. I like the idea, sort of, but it don't work. Oh, we got the Gizmo's Fabricator with a very fancy border. Is that even a Magic the Gathering border? 4 generic for a legendary artifact with apparently not even a creature. Okay, tap, create a token that's a copy of a non-legendary artifact card in your hand or graveyard. Holy crap, your hand? Pay 3, tap, search your library for an artifact card, reveal it, and put it into your hand? And you don't even have to pay anything. So basically, for 4 mana, you put this thing in play, and you just tap it, and it turns into anything you want in your hand, and multiple copies of that same card. You know what's interesting, though? This card works. Like, there's nothing broken. There's the design is perfect. 4 mana, tap, create a token that's a copy of a non-legendary artifact card in hand or graveyard. Note, reveal it if it's in your hand. I almost feel like this had some human assistance to make this thing. At least it is legendary. So you can't copy itself, just in case it's too broken. Of course, this is too broken. It's just 4 mana and just put some insane card into play with haste. You could put Grizzlebrand in play. Everyone would play this. Turn 2, you could have this out with Soul Ring and just tap and start going ham. AA created Conjure from MTG. Yeah, I guess so. The Zybers like it. This is insane. It's not broken, but it's OP. I think that card is broken. I mean, like, a lot of decks can get... In Commander, anyone can get this thing out on turn 2. And then you just start copying some stupid nonsense from your hand and spam it over and over and over again. Oh yeah, I can't. Okay, sorry. I can't. It can't be Grizzlebrand. It's got to be. Okay, so what are we limited to? Like Blight Steel? No, it's got to be a non-legendary. Oh, did they know exactly how to word this? What's the most broken artifact that we can copy? Yeah, we gotta copy an artifact that untaps. All right, yeah. Maybe what's it called? Voltaic Key. Copy Soul Ring to copy Soul Ring. More Soul Rings. Copy of non-legendary artifact. Do you know what? The fact that it's gotta be a non-legendary artifact, I didn't realize how narrow that is. Maybe this is playable. You can copy multiple millstones. Oh yes. Mill them out. You can't copy Gizmo's Fabricator. Get Worm Coil. I guess it's not that broken. Turn 3 Mindslaver, but you still gotta activate it. Is there an artifact creature that untaps artifacts? I don't think so. Phyrexian Worm, Fractured Power Stone. Like Blight, the Blight Steel's all legendary, right? I think they're all legendary. So actually, it's really hard to break this card. All right, it's fair. I think it's, all of a sudden, I think it's fair. Yeah, you get Inkwell, Worm Coil. That's not going to do it. It's really not that big of a deal. All right, you heard the music. We're going to look at more AI generated cards. You can skip through if you want, but don't leave my video. We're going to thank FusionGamingOnline.com, today's sponsor. My first place I go to get my Phyrexia All Will Be One singles and also March of the Machine singles. And don't forget that when you purchase cards from FusionGamingOnline.com, whether it be for your Pioneer, Commander, or Modern deck, don't forget to use coupon code Nikachu at checkout for 5% off all your purchases. We're also going to thank Mana Traders, the premier place for renting Magic cards online. I had an idea. What if True Name Nemesis in Legacy is unnecessary? So I played Legacy the other day, and I didn't have any Force of Wills or Wastelands, so what did I do? I rented them from Mana Traders. You too can support the channel by using my Mana Traders link in the description below, or save 10% off your first 2 months using coupon code Nikachu_3RS. Alright, back to the wild west of weird Magic the Gathering cards. The fake name Nemesis. Worm Coil every turn is broken. In Commander, is it really? I don't know. In Pony Commander, maybe. Gatsu Blargings. It is an Eura. I don't even know what the card type is, to be honest. Creature, I guess. It's got power and toughness. We got black 7 tap. Tap type. There's a lot more text, and this is already a pretty rough start. Protections from creatures you control have Numon creature toughness for 7 green creature token. Zonst creature token. At the beginning of your upkeep, scry 1, +1/+1 until end of turn. Actually, this serves the big buzzer. Not only, it's just completely unintelligible, and you can't even read this thing. Everyone get that one? The Zonst is Zyber. Me when I scry a counter. Says Cyborg Gaming. Yeah, the tap type sounds like a dance. Oh no, not Zonst. Where's the Zonst? Yeah, Zonst creature token. Gotta Zonst it. Oh goodness. Yeah, shred for nonsense. Complete nonsense. These are those comical, this is the comic relief on this channel. Or on these shows. It reads like a Dr. Seuss book. Yeah, except you really don't know what it's saying. It's Zonstense. It's Zonsense. Oh, yes. Alright, moving on. This is awful. What an awful card. The Gloom Widow. Ooh, it's an artifact land. Some might say that's already broken. If Gloom Widow is in your opening hand, you may begin the game with it on the battlefield. All creatures get -2/-2. What are you, nuts? It's not even legendary. It's not even legendary. You could have millions of these Gloom Widows and just, it would be the most oppressive thing to all creatures ever. Yeah, it danger. This thing's super it danger. Oh my god, it danger. It does not Zyber. There's no way in hell this Zybers. Basically, goodbye. I mean, it's the ultimate elf killer. I'll give it that. Gloom the bird. It doesn't tap. Okay, so here's the good news. This card actually doesn't tap for mana. It's just an artifact land that, I don't know. What is this? Some sort of radioactive wasteland? Hence, it's the Gloom Widow. It kills the Zybers, that's for sure. Best AI control card ever. Oh yeah, it's Elish Norn on a land. Elish Norn for free. Just put on the battlefield. It's gonna wipe out all the goblins. It should be mine. No, it should be nothing! Because these stack. It's not a legendary card, so they just stack on top of each other. Fair if... Maybe... That's interesting. I mean, I still think I would hate it still. Man, the idea of like lands being able to reduce the power of my creatures. No. You stay away from my creatures. No touchies. All creatures get -2/-2. This would be a hell of a game to play with these AI generated cards. It's like Tabernacle, except, I don't know, worse in some way. I think it's worse. Because it could just nuke the thing, even if I have the mana to pay for it. Yeah, it's the Tabernacle of... What's a card that gives -2/-2 of... like a sorcery of some sort. You start with 4 of those, yeah. Oh yeah, you could start... I forgot, if it's in your opening hand, you just put it onto the battlefield. So it like doesn't even count as your land drop. So it's a Leyline Tabernacle artifact land. This card is absolutely bonkers nuts. It's a legendary artifact, so it combos with that create a co- Oh no! Oh no, yeah, it combos with Gizmo's Fabricator. So just keep putting that stupid thing in play until everything gets like -20/-20. Just infinitely. For forever. You see, the AI is starting to build a deck here, people. They're building a deck. Like, this is gonna be the greatest deck ever. Artifacts seem to be strong. Tokens seem to be strong. How do we make them all together? And ley lines look like a good idea. Robert! Massacre Worm gonna love this card. Absolutely. It might actually be fair if I had cumulative upkeep. Well, anything is fair with cumulative upkeep. You save me, Blood Moon! Blood Moon, the savior of the day. Dies to Blood Moon. Well, it doesn't die, it just becomes a bump on the log, right? It just becomes like a red artifact land. A red non-basic artifact. Anyway, okay, disgusting card. Very disgusting. Holy cr- 6 loyalty abilities? Really? Avacyn, the Grim Shepherd. So red, 5 generic for 3 loyalty. It's an angel, of course. Shouldn't it be Avacyn, though? Avacyn's real name is Angel. She is the angel of all angels. Alright, +1. Discard a card. If you do, return another creature card from your graveyard to the battlefield tapped and attacking. Do I have to... Well, it's 5... Sorry, it's 9... Sorry, it's 7 mana. It's 7 mana, so I don't know. Maybe this is not that broken. That's a lot of mana! But at the same time, that's a pretty stupid ability. We've already... The loyalty abilities aren't even in order. Ah, they never are. The AI hasn't figured out that they have to start with plus and go all the way down to minus. Yeah, it's 7 mana, so maybe it's fair in that context. Maybe. Okay, -2. Avacyn, the Grim Shepherd, deals 3 damage to target multicolored creature. That's fair. We're going to be rating these abilities. -1. Put 2 +1/+1 counters on each up to 3 target creatures. That is also fair. +1, create a 1/1 green sapling creature token. A little off flavor, but not broken. -1, search your library for a basic land card, reveal it, put it into your hand, then shuffle your library. That is also fair. -7, creatures you control with flying get +1/+1 until end of turn. That is outrageously fair. It's funny, the most broken ability is this top one. I guess this passes. Yeah, the most underpowered -7 of all time. That ultimate! We're going to get +1/+1 until end of turn. The finisher. We're going to get there with all those creating sapling tokens and apparently reanimating stuff onto the battlefield. turn another target, another creature card from your grave. It's like, so how does this even card even work? Okay, this top ability, it's like you go straight into the attack step. So we discard a card, and if we do, we return a creature card from the graveyard to the battlefield tapped and attacking. It's like, okay, instantly we're now in the attack step. That ability might not work. It might not work. Six ability. No, I think the first one is good. Yeah, the first is very good. Although it may not make sense. These feel like a Planeswalker if they made Planeswalkers in 4th edition. Yeah, maybe. All Planeswalker ultimates are either a dangerous or overcosted, or yeah, or you never even want to use it because it's useless. You can't even activate the first one outside of combat. Well, that's what I'm saying. Like, does the first one work because we just go immediately into combat? Or is it just like attacking in the first main phase and it's just waiting for the blocker step? Yeah, tapped and attacking is awkward on a Planeswalker. It's never been done before. The AI was like, why hasn't anyone tried to do this? I know. This is going to be a plus one ability. Feel like the computer accidentally switched the numbers around. I think it knows what it's doing. Okay, for this plus one, I guess we have to... I don't know if it technically works, so we're going to have to say that the whole card is a bust. But it was close. It was really close. The Farty Drow. All right. So you've been going to Taco Bell, I hear. So white, one generic for a human artificer creature with no power or toughness, nothing. And when you cast this spell, it's got the ability. When you cast this spell, and that's it. Cut it off right there. When you cast this spell... Okay, hold on. I gotta go to the bathroom. I got gas. It's that farty drow sort of thing. It's like... This is what happens when the card has been, like, in development. And they accidentally printed a card in development. But they didn't finish it. When you cast this spell, you fart. I guess that's it, yeah. Silent but deadly. I was about to say something like that. When you cast this spell... Do I have a farting sound effect here? No, I don't. So, it's silent but deadly. You don't hear anything. Oh, what happened? Who did that? Who did that? The art is so good. It is pretty... It's pretty good art. And it has nothing to do with the card. Unless she's looking at you, she knows what she's about to do. Creature with power or toughness. Yeah, I guess so. It's like a fart. It enters and disappears because no power and toughness. It comes and goes like a fart to the wind. Have you even farted? No. Okay, Blue Bomber. Just change it to creature gains haste and must attack this turn. Oh, you must be talking about the last card. Yes, that's how it would be. That's exactly how it would be fixed. Tell that to the AI, though. Thank you very much for the super chat, Blue Bomber. Alright, moving on. We got the Dread-Heared, the Living Protection for Cat. That's nice. This must be the Dread-Heared Living Protection. Here's the cat. It's a land, so we can tap for a generic mana, or colorless. And then we can pay a white tap. Sacrifice a goblin. That makes a whole lot of sense. Reveal the top card of your library. The high bidder creature without flying would deal this mana cost to that permanent or player instead. What if we just put a bunch of words together in a tumbler and it rumbles around and then spews out into an ability? What would happen? And would it work? And the answer is no, it wouldn't. For cat, sack a goblin. They don't like cat, or the cat don't like the goblin. Ship for nonsense. Who is the bidder? I don't know who the bidder is. It's one of the gibberish cards. Set symbol is not aligned equals shred. What is the set symbol? The set symbol's, yeah, down over here. MTG Mad Libs. Except worse. Way worse. The high bidder creature without flying would deal this mana cost to that permanent player instead. Yeah, Mad Libs for Magic the Gathering. Insert magic term here. Yeah, only cats understand. They would know better than we do. They like to play with the goblins, like they like to play with mice. translation from cat language gone wrong. Yeah, maybe. Google Translate from cat to English. And now it doesn't make sense. Also, are you not allowed to sell if you draw one? Reveal the top card of your library, the high bidder creature. I don't know. All right, I'm done with this one. We go the Gogold Stirred. It's a green 3 generic 5/5 nothing. Has no card type. Comey them Castergangstald. Create a 2/2 blur insect. I'm assuming this is some sort of ETB or something. Or I don't know, upon cast. Or on the way to dying. I'm just trying to figure something out. It's 4 mana for a 5/5 though. It's not too bad. Comey! Comey at me, bro. Comey a danger. Robert, thanks so much for the super chat. My cat is a master of psychological manipulation, as all cats are. They're good at that. It's the one thing they are good at. AI been drinking, accidentally incorporating German cards in the training set. Does it sound German? I would know nothing. Comey them Castergangstald is a perfectly fair ability. Ship it. Yeah, at the very least, we have no idea how this gets executed, but at the very least, it's a 5/5 for 4 mana, and somehow we get a 2/2 insect. Somehow. Can't even fly. I would love a stream of cards where we want to play, but can't make work. I think we have done stuff like that, but you know what? Maybe we could do something very similar. Thank you very much for the idea, can't even fly. Juzam Dijin, eat your heart out. That's right. Eat your heart out. Alright, so we're gonna... anyway, I'm just gonna give this the buzzer. It don't make sense. So we're gonna move on to the Burning Design. It's a 2-mana, 1/1 mirror. You hear that, mirror people? You just merely had to wait for the AI mirror. Flying, Vigilance, Trample, and Haste. Oh, good God. They're starting out hard here. This is like they looked at the mirror landscape and saw that they all sucked. So like we need to make the one mirror to rule them all. Looks like Sauron to me as well. Other soldier creatures you control get +1/+0. Wow, this mirror has already betrayed the mirrors. Whenever Burning Design blocks a creature with flying, death touch, and haste, and the sentence didn't end. This spell costs 1 less to cast for each instant and sorcery card in your graveyard. Okay, so you could play this for free at some point. And then channel a red 2 generic discard Burning Design. Target creature can't block this turn. It's almost a card. Man, it's just this whole when Burning Design blocks a creature with flying, death touch, and haste. And then it just sort of lost it right there and just lost the thread. Yeah, guess I'll die. Yes, that's right. Whenever it blocks something with death touch, I guess I'm a goner. Don't even need to end that sentence. Yeah, it could be a zero cost mirror if you have enough instant or sorceries in your graveyard. But it doesn't buff the mirror. It buffs the soldiers for some stupid reason. What a Burning Design this is. Other soldiers doesn't work since it's not a soldier. Well, it's like those old, like the old lords, Lord of Atlantis, Goblin King. They didn't buff each other up. They were like lords to the other cards. So it's just classic design, that's all. Lore-wise, it makes sense. It's supporting the rebellion. I don't know anything about the mirrors. Cross-tribal benefits. Affinity for instants and sorceries. So, maybe it has death touch whenever it blocks a creature with flying or something. I don't know. But because of that one ability, it got ruined. Otherwise, I think this is somewhat fair. Like a 1/1 flyer for 2 mana. That is Vigilance and Trample. Like, why not? Why not? Faith Sacrion. A black, blue, white, 1 generic Planeswalker. And the name of this Planeswalker is 4. Must be related to Ren and 6. And 4 has 4 loyalty. +2, look at target player's hand and choose an online card from that player's hand. X, hold on, you just choose it? I choose you. I choose this one. I like it. Okay, minus X. Target player discards two cards. You lose three life, and you draw X cards. Target player discard. That's not bad. Okay, so you can make someone discard two cards. You lose three life, but then you can draw, like, up to four cards. Not the most insane thing, to be honest. I guess it's pretty fair. Minus three. Each player loses two life unless any player pays one. Discard your graveyard. Okay, now that we've done... We lost it! Discard your graveyard. Search the other cards. Untap it until end of turn. And then we have minus four. You search your library for up to any many of that counter from a permanent. Create those cards for as long as it has the most common. Doing next of its owner's hand. And then you draw a card. Create a treasure token. And if it's a... And if T... It is gets plus two until end of turn. Man, it just unraveled so quickly there. It was like, it made so much sense in the beginning, and then it just imploded on itself. Yeah, any many of this card. Discard your graveyard. Discard your graveyard. Each player loses two life unless any player pays one. Then we discard our graveyards. But then where do they go? Do they go the exile zone? I don't know. When you discard from hand, it goes to graveyard. When you discard graveyard, where does it go? Have you ever farted on live stream? Tons of times. You just never hear it. I'm very quiet. It took the AI 80 years to make this card. Started getting Alzheimer's towards the end. Did it slowly. It makes sense. Goddamn people, it's just fine. Discard triggers happen again. Oh, that's interesting. That's possible. So Kev K says, maybe when we discard our graveyard, we get discard triggers all over again, like as if it just hit the graveyard. It's like you blinked your graveyard. Maybe that's the whole point. Cyborg Gaming, discard your graveyard could be broken with cards that trigger on discard. Cyborg Gaming also agrees. Reminds me of that one discard library. Discard your library. Just dump it. The Thassa's Oracle. Combo. Okay, well, anyway, it's still getting the buzzer. This is a nonsense card. We have a lot of planeswalkers today. Okay, we got Tajir, the first familiar for a black, green, and two generic. We got foil late. It's Nissa! Nissa, you're now parading yourself as Tajir! You're not fooling us, though. We know you're Nissa. Alright, so plus one. You gain two life. Minus one, you may pay two life. If you do, create a 2/2 black zombie creature token. Oh, Nissa. You went to the dark side, didn't you? You went to learn the dark arts. And she renamed herself Tajir. Okay, and then minus three. When you cast your next instant or sorcery spell this turn, copy that spell. You may choose new targets for the copy. Oh my god, it's like, it's been a million years since we see an actual card. This is a real card. Kind of like Onyx. Yeah, exactly. Professor Onyx. Oh, Professor. Off flavor. Well, we don't know if it's off flavor. It's possible. We don't know the lore behind this. She got bored of the living and went to the dead. She found some... She started turning dead things in the forest into zombies. Oh, yeah. The plus one and minus one synergy. We got that synergy over there. It makes sense and it's fair. This one's a keeper. Who would play Tajir in their deck? Let me know in the comments section. Ooh, nice mountain. It's a Bob Ross mountain. Oh my god! This is a word soup card. Okay, Firebolt Riposte. Black, blue, one generic. It's an instant. Do we have to zoom in on this thing? What happened here? Okay, I'm zooming in. Okay, I'll tell you what it does. Choose one. Target player loses one life and you gain two life. Draw two cards. Oh, you only choose one. Okay, exile the top 10 cards of your library face down. Destroy target spirit. That's insanely specific. Destroy target creature and opponent controls. Return target permanent to its owner's hand. Counter target activated or triggered ability. Prevent all damage that would be dealt this turn. Counter target enchantment spell, And lastly, target creature gains flying until end of turn. Oh, for the low cost of a black, a blue, one generic. It's the most unbelievable. It's like, how can we get a card to do everything? It's like someone said, AI, this card can't do everything. No, wait a minute. Hold my beer. It can. 10 sentences, choose one when R&D hits the card limit. it's like, you know what? I have all these ideas for cards, but they all suck by themselves. Why don't we just jam them all into the same card? Okay, target player loses one life, you gain two life. Is that really broken for three mana? Not really. Draw two cards, also not broken. Exile the top 10 cards of your library face down, also not broken. Destroy target spirit. How many people play spirits out there? Sorry, MTG Ectoplasm. This card is going to rip you apart. Destroy target creature and opponent controls. Now that's good. That's pretty damn good. So the fact that it's at least a removal spell for 3 mana. Not the most mana efficient thing to do, but you can do a lot of stuff. It also bounces stuff. Oh, and counters triggered abilities. Wait, is this as good? Oh wait, yeah, you're right. Maybe this is the same thing as Archmage's Charm, but it doesn't counter spells. It does everything Archmage's. It's like a super Archmage's Charm, except do not counter spells. It's the only thing it can't do. The spell has to resolve unless it's an enchantment spell. Counter target enchantment spell. All those abilities are fair. Well, I guess you can only choose one. How do we get everyone to play the same card in their Dimir deck? The ultimate Dimir staple. But here's a question. Would this see Legacy play? Seriously, would this see Legacy play? I don't think this would see Legacy. I don't know. Maybe as a one or two of in a sideboard? Just in case you needed to bounce something? The destroy target creature for 3 mana is not OP, though. Yeah, Dark Banishing with slightly more complex casting cost. Every ability is like super fair, but it's so flexible. You could basically do anything. So PM says way too weak for Legacy. 3 mana and Legacy. Yeah, it could be too. If it's too expensive for Legacy, then maybe it's fair. All right, I'll give it a pass. Okay, we're gonna pass the Firebolt Rip Post. As bizarre as this is, what Reddit is this? This is actually we're on Twitter right now. Robo Rosewater M. Go look up Robo Rosewater M for all the crazy AI-generated cards. Argothian Liege. A white, six generic 4/4 spirit. Which can be blown up, by the way, by the Firebolt Rip Post. So automatically, you know, the AI already was trying to build a metagame. Build the answers to the oppressive cards in this metagame. So we have a 4/4 spirit. At the beginning of your upkeep, you may Bolve your hand. Okay, do we have an explanation for what Bolve is? I choose not to. To Bolve or not to Bolve? That is the question. I was hoping for an explanation. I don't see it here. Maybe it's strong. Maybe it's not. Maybe Bolve means you like double your hand. I don't know. Bolve too oppressive. Bolve it, bro. I hate it when my cards get Bolved. Nobody likes it when their hand gets Bolved. Bolve your hand equals it danger. I thought Bolve was Zyber Tribal. It was written. Okay, one generation at temp zero. Bolve your hand. You may discard any number of cards. Draw that many cards plus one. That's pretty sick. Okay. So you may discard any number of cards and draw that many cards. Plus one. So you could just discard one card and then draw two. That's value. That's insane. At the beginning of your upkeep. So you just keep, like, you draw an extra card every turn. But it's 8 mana. Bolve on 8 mana? Maybe that's fair. Yeah, Bolve at 8 mana may be fair. Bolvshevik. Yeah, maybe it's fine. Okay, I guess I'll get... You know what? If you want to have a new hand every single turn, plus one card at 8 mana, I guess this is okay. Maybe Bolve could be like a mulligan. Well, it sort of is like a mulligan. It's like... what's the card? You get to choose the mulligan cards. All right. The Fist of... Fist the Hearth. Fistum. They're taking it literally. It's a 2 mana colorless enchantment. as far as I see. Very neat picture. I like the pixel art thing. You may play cards you own from outside the game. You may cast that card this turn, and you may spend mana as though it were mana of any color to you. Duffing those land. Oh my god. It's like, why? You're so close. You're at the finish line. AI, you were at the finish line, and then you screwed it up. You basically tripped over your own shoes. Well, we sort of know what this card was supposed to say. They just messed it up at the end. So, like, assuming it, you may spend mana of any color. You may spend mana as though it were mana of any color, period. You didn't have to go any further. That's all you had to do. You just had to end the sentence. English doesn't come naturally to the AI. And if it did that, this is a cool card. I think this is a cool card. Start off broken. Is it really broken? You can just play cards you own from outside the game. Oh, but okay, I get it. So even if you're playing cards from your sideboard, it's like pay to draw 7 cards. So maybe it is. Yeah. Maybe this is broken. Okay, I'm stupid. There's nothing fair about this whatsoever. 2 mana, draw 15. Well, not, you know, have 15 because you started the game with 7. How do you derf a land? I don't know. You duffing those lands. Why do half of these keywords the AI invents sound like stoner slang? Because they are stoned. AI was tipsy and slurred the speech. Can we bulve our sideboard? Oh, that's a good question. Probably not, because it's not part of your hand. Okay, it exile still considered outside the game? No. By today's standards, outside the game means your sideboard. Remove from the game means exile. Outside the game means specifically your sideboard. Not your trade binder, not your local game store if you own the local game store. Just the 15 cards in your sideboard. That's it. Single target duffing is okay. I think it's pronounced doofing, but I'm not as dumb as AI, so I'm not sure. Bolving while duffing is very dueling. You guys are going deep. The AI did make a lot of synergistic cards today. Alright, so. We got the Roiling Aether General. Black, black, one generic for a 2/2 elk. Tap, counter target activated ability from an artifact, creature, or enchantment spell that targets an enchantment or creature card in your graveyard. That is weird. So you can tap. So, like, you can. I don't know the full use of this card, but. The. What's it called? I know you could, like, counter a Scavenging Ooze ability. That's about it. It's the most metal elk art ever. Yeah, I guess this is the one elk to rule them all. It's larger than an island. Can you see that? There's like a little island over here, and the elk is ginormous. Seth with the super chat. I have an AI card that I put on our custom magic, Vanishing Dragon. The only difference is the original was black. Remind me when we do custom magic cards next week. I'm not in the position to look up the card right now. Just remind me, Seth. Donate 25 cents or something. I owe the magpie a custom card. Oddly specific, but fair. It works. It's very real. It's too fair, in fact. Too fair. It's actually a weird ability for a black card. Or maybe not. Countering stuff. The, what's it called? The, black is, a friend of blue. Sprout, blue, destroy target artifact or enchantment for a single blue? That's not, that color pie is broken. And then Gloom is a, can I show this to you guys? Hold on. Then we got Gloom, target creature gets -2/-2 until end of turn. And you can fuse them together. Pay 3 mana, kill a creature, blow up an artifact or enchantment. That's insane. The fact that blue can now blow up artifacts and enchantments. Oh my god, I was waiting for this my entire life. My entire life. Fuse card is danger. Sprout and Gloom is such an AI. Yeah, Sprout and Gloom. Sprout then Gloom. That doesn't even make any sense. Why is it called Sprout after we destroy the artifact? Or is it like we blew up machinery? We blew up... the industrialized world, and now things can sprout. Although it does make sense. Like, they have the sprout and then they have the gloom. It's just that the abilities don't make any sense with each other. Or, like, the sprout ability doesn't make any sense. Should be sprout and bloom. No, it's gloom because the thing is dying. See? Look, it's dying. First it sprouted and then they killed it. It's like you water your own plant and then you stop watering it. Oh, I like that. You blew it up. From Karsten. You blew it up! You fools! You evolve Bellsprout into Gloom. Thank you very much for the super chat, Tetra Tim Bowman. Also, thanks for the super chat, Flonino. I appreciate it. Dimir gets all the good cards today. They do. And also the artifact cards. I mean, it's a real card. I mean, I don't know how good people will feel about blue having artifact enchantment destruction for a single mana. It's wild. Man, the artworks were beautiful. Perfect artwork. They're real cards, though. It's a real card. Nothing broken here. Okay, we got the Skurin Bombass. Blue 3 generic enchantment. Players play with their hands. You don't say! What was I going to play with otherwise? And what are they talking about? These hands or like the cards in my hand? Players play with their hands. Or am I supposed to like... Are they talking about this? This is me playing with my hands? Also, vote. Do you feel anxiety or do you feel calmness when you hear the sound of cards shuffling? People have two different feelings around this sound effect. Some people associate this with cheating. Other people just associate it with a good old competitive day at the local game store. What if you play on Magic the Gathering Online or Arena? I don't know! I don't know what to do anymore, so I can't play with my foot anymore. It's correct, you cannot. Maybe it's like you can't play with cards from anywhere but your hand. Maybe that's real. So that like hits, you can't, that nails commanders, that nails companions, it nails cards from outside the game. Interesting. No flashback or no feet. Players play with their hands. Maybe you can't play anything from your graveyard. It's just a weirdly worded card to restrict what you're allowed to play with. You can do everything only from your hand. Jesus Christ, the fingers. How many? Maybe six fingers. Yeah, the AI be like that sometimes. And also, it's two right hands. It's two right hands. Look at the thumb over here. We have a thumb and five digit in fingers, and then we have another thumb, I'm guessing, over here. Otherwise, they're like messed up. I mean, they're on the wrong sides. I love how the AI just tries to figure out, like, you know, human anatomy like this. Figure it out as it goes. It's phrased like an alpha beta. It is. Is this a JoJo reference? I don't know. It's not broken because it still lets you bolve your hand. Ship it. All right, we're going to ship it. Players play with their hands. Okay, we got Tekrith Raiders Apex of the Hunt. It's a black, blue, blue, six generic planeswalker. That is nine man. It's Chandra. Chandra's underneath all of this. All right, five loyalty, plus one. Target player mills 10 cards. Minus three, destroy all non-land permanents. Search your library. Oh, no, that's it. Just minus three, destroy all non-land permanents. Just blow it up, including itself or herself. Chandra blows herself up. And then minus 10, search your library for a creature card and put it onto the battlefield and shuffle your library. It's actually quite fair in the grand scheme of things. For nine mana, not bad. All right. All right, Chandra, you do you. Living Light. Oh, I don't want to read this. Red, five generic for a sorcery. All right, here we go. Get your popcorn ready and sit back and enjoy the show. Living Light deals three damage to target creature. Search your library for an instant card named Living Light Tesser. That player puts the card's revealer. That player draw cards of the chosen type revealed this way onto the battlefield. At the beginning of the next end step, sacrifice those creatures until end of turn. They may cast that card without paying its mana cost. An opponent chooses a card from their graveyard. If the player does, return Living Light to the battlefield. That player mills half the rest in Stoud. Each player returns all token cards from their graveyard to the battlefield. You know what? They lost me at, if a player does return Living Light to the battlefield. You cannot return sorceries to the battlefield. That doesn't make any sense. I'm not going to make any comment for the rest of it. Guardian of the Princes. Princes. Blue 2 generic for a 2/2 bird wolf. What the hell? So it's a bird. So they are, the AI is getting ready for those combination cards now. You know, with like the Thalia and the Gitrog. We now got the bird and the wolf. It's a wolf riding a bird. I love it. And he's having a great time too. Yeah, bird wolf. Bushido 1. It's a 2/2, by the way. Creatures with a mountain walk can be blocked. All right. So if you have a mountain walk, you can block those guys. Whenever you cast a white spell, Guardian of the Princes gains Shroud until end of turn. Wow, that's actually pretty good. So that's a pretty nice ability at the end. It's funny, this card, even though it's a bird, it doesn't fly. Maybe because the wolf is like basically weighing it down and it's really low to the ground. So the flavor's on point. Yeah, suck it, Goblin King. Hoses those Mountain Walk decks. It's very specific, but it's very real. It's a good card that don't like Mountain Walk. You just play any white card. Just play any white card and has Shroud until end of turn. I forget how Bushido works. I don't know how Bushido works. What if I try to stick a white aura on it? It will fizzle, actually. It'll fizzle. So if you cast a white spell targeting Guardian of the Princes, the trigger of getting Shroud will go on the stack above Guardian of the Princes, and then you'll lose your aura. Guardian of the Mountains from above. Clearly not an African swallow. Physics, yeah, hold on, where physics at work there, can't fly because too heavy. Can we get like a closer look at this guy? Bird doesn't seem as thrilled as the wolf. God damn it, wolf, can you not lose a few pounds, damn it. Alright, Jaya's Expernation. A blue-white, one generic, three loyalty planeswalker. There's a lot of planeswalkers today. Plus one, up to one target creature gets plus two until end of turn. Minus two, target creature gets plus three, and gains trample until end of turn. You gain life equal to its converted mana cost. Okay, that's fine. We get trample. Sorry, it gets trample plus three, and we gain life equal to its mana value. Minus six, you get an emblem with pay red two, sacrifice another creature, return target creature card from your graveyard to the battlefield. And also has a random ability at the bottom. One and a Simic. Return target creature to its owner's hand. Oh my god, that last ability. Planeswalkers with actual abilities on it. And you can do that repeatedly over and over again. It's creepy art. Eh. It's like, it's one of those things where if you like cover up half of the face, it would look normal. But if you take these two of them combined, it looks odd. Is the ability part of the emblem? I don't think so. I think it's there's a clear break there. Clear break. I think it's its own thing. You guys think it's part of the emblem? You think it's part of the emblem? We'll make it part of the emblem. Then that emblem is broken. But it's hard to get to because you got to go like +1, +1, +1, -6. So it takes literally four turns, which is on par for most like planeswalker abilities anyway. Look at the commas. What about the commas? Oh, yeah, you're right. Okay, there's a comma starting here. There's a comma ending here. Okay, I got it. Yeah. All right, it's part of the emblem. It's part of the emblem. And this ability is broken. Well, it's a great... Okay, but it works. The whole thing makes sense. I can't believe it. With all those words, it actually made sense in the end. What do we got here? Okay. Ziza, the Mirror's Relic. Red, four generic for a four loyalty. Ziza. +1, create two 1/1 white soldier creature tokens with vigilance. And pay X. Return target creature card with converted mana cost X from your graveyard to the battlefield. And then you create a token that's a copy of it. That's pretty neat, actually. It's definitely very legal. There's nothing broken about this card at all. Hold on. Let's go back to this. People wanted to see some turtle. You guys wanted to see this thing? Useless Blob. Green, 3 generic for a 1-1 ooze. Whenever Useless Blob attacks, it deals 1 damage. Just, what? What is going on here? Whenever it attacks, it killed itself in confusion. Can I show you guys better? There we go. It's a Useless Blob. It really is a Useless Blob. Unbelievable. Send it in. Okay, well, it's a legal card. It's not broken. The music that kills the stream is playing. I know, it does. Alright, you heard the music. So that's what happens. The show's got to end at some point. Well, where's my... Got to move everything around. Alright, thank you very much for joining me today. We do this Monday to Friday, 11 o'clock a.m. Central Standard Time. Be there or be square. Thanks, everyone, for the support. Everyone who's a member on YouTube, patron on Patreon, and also everyone who super chats. You're a huge contributor to the channel and keeps it going every single morning. But most importantly, you guys that show up in the morning, you're everything to me. Thank you very much, Peter, Sarka, Bread, Tetra, PM, Diamantem, Seth, Peter, Thema, Fricade, Richard, King Ginger, Osef, Fricade, Hafiz, Abzo. Thank you very much, everyone, for being a part of Coffee and MTG. Thank you, my coffee crew. So, you know, as usual, keep brewing up them coffees, and we'll keep brewing up the magic. Take care of yourselves, and I will see you at the next one.